guys. So today I'm going to be ranking all of my past favorite books. I have gone through every single favorites video that I've posted on YouTube. I've been making BookTube videos since 2013. Actually, I think that my second or third video ever was my best books of 2013, not including my favorite books video that I just posted. I have 8 years worth of favorites that I'm going to be ranking and determining if they are still my favorite books. So here are my ranking categories. I did not make these up. I stole this tier ranking from Kayla from Books and Lala. But starting from the bottom going up, we have What the Fuck Was I Thinking? I Take It Back. These are gonna be books that I have since changed my opinion on. Then I have books that I need to reread. These are gonna be ones that I just don't know if they're still favorites. They might be, but I would need to reread them. Then above that, we have Stand By It. These are ones that might not necessarily be my favorite books right now, but I stand by it as a choice for my favorite book at the time that I said. And then the very top tier are my all-time faves. These are the ones that are still my favorite books to this day. So let's get into the ranking. I have already sorted all of these books out by year. So we're gonna go through the years, and I think it's also gonna be kind of interesting to see how my reading taste evolved, because let me just say, I think that I have good taste now in books. That was not always the case. Okay, so we're going back, time traveling back to 2013. To give a little context, I was 17. So these are 17-year-old Riley's favorite books. So the first one, starting off strong, we have Obsidian by Jennifer L. Armentrout. I feel like I want to say that I stand by it, but I also take it back. Here's my thinking on this. I stand by this as my favorite at the time because I was obsessed with this book. I remember this whole series I read in 2 days. I have a vivid memory of it being over Christmas, and my grandparents were in town, so my family had to go to Christmas Eve church service. I distinctly remember sitting at the service, and I had my Kindle, and I was reading this series, and my mom got really mad at me. But like, then again, I also take it back because objectively, these weren't good. They're Twilight with aliens. I'm gonna go take it back. I take it back. Honestly, this might be controversial, but I take back every Jennifer L. Armentrout book I've ever liked. I don't think she's a very good writer. Oh my God, starting this video off with controversy. Okay, next one we have is The Great Gatsby, and I'm immediately putting this in What the Fuck Was I Thinking, solely for the reason that I know I was lying. I know that I was lying putting this on my favorites list. So I'm pretty sure that I had just read this for school. And I mean, I didn't hate this book, but a favorite? No, ma'am. No, ma'am. I think I was just trying to be like, I like classics, you know? But I picked The Great Gatsby for that. I don't know. But that's immediately What the Fuck Was I Thinking. The next one is Poison Study by Maria V. Snyder, and that is going to all-time fave. This is one of my all-time favorite books still to this day. I reread this book every single year, and I love it. This book came out in like 2004, 2005, and I think it still holds up today. This is technically an adult book, but I really think that this was like the blueprint for current YA fantasy. A lot of the tropes that were presented in this trilogy are ones that now seem very like overdone and cliche in YA fantasy, but like Poison Study was the girl. She was the girl who everybody copied. And I love this trilogy. The next book is Eleanor Park by Rainbow Rowell, and I take it back. Not even just for like the problematic elements of this book. I can't really speak on the criticisms over the Asian representation in this book, because like I said, I read this almost 10 years ago, and I definitely wasn't critically thinking or using my brain at all when I was reading back then. So aside from that, I take it back genuinely because I just don't think Rainbow Rowell is that good. 13 Reasons Why. Another book that I take back for a myriad of reasons. I think that I had read this before 2013. I have a distinct memory of reading this in like middle school, and 2013 was my last year of high school. So I think that this was a reread and I put it in my favorites list. But again, like I feel like this was just 17-year-old Riley trying to be edgy, but Jay Asher, no ma'am. And this book has a ton of problems, so I take it back. Shatter Me by Tahereh Mafi. I'm gonna take it back. Oh my God. I'm gonna take it back for the sole reason that I don't remember this book at all. I can't tell you one thing about this book. What was it about? I don't know. Who were the characters? I think somebody named Warren. That sounds familiar. But other than that, I don't know. So obviously it didn't stick with me, and I'm taking it back. Legend by Marie Lu. This one, you know what? I'm gonna stand by this one. This was like around the time that I was reading like every dystopian YA series that there was. And I remember that this one out of all of them was one that I liked the most. Now, would I still like it today if I read it? I don't know. But I stand by it for the time. I feel like I'm being very harsh on my 2013 books. The next one is The Fault in Our Stars by John Green. See, this one today, Riley wants to take it back. However, I'm gonna stand by it because I understand why, being the person that I was when I was 17, why I loved this and why I connected with this so much. I have since reread it, didn't enjoy it as much, so it's not a favorite anymore, but I stand by it being my favorite book in 2013. So the last 2013 book is Hex Hall by Rachel Hawkins. I don't know, I feel like I would need to reread it because I remember that I really loved it. I had so much fun. It reminded me of like Halloween Town. I read the whole trilogy. I like have vague memories of it, but I don't remember enough to determine. So I'm gonna put that on need to reread. Now, moving into 2014, this was my first like official year being a booktuber. So the first favorite was Under the Never Sky by Veronica Rossi. And I'm gonna stand by this because I was obsessed with this trilogy. I remember I loved this love interest so much. He was my favorite love interest at the time with all the books that I was reading. And I thought that this world was really, really cool. I kind of wanna put it in need to reread because I would love to reread this, but I stand by this one. Then we have Fangirl, also by Rainbow Rowell, which I'm taking back. The grip that Rainbow Rowell had on all of us in 2014, we needed help. We needed help. We needed to escape. Looking back, her books are just, like, they're fine. They're just bland. They're bland. Okay, so then we have these three Colleen Hoover books. I'm pretty sure that in this year, 2014, I read every Colleen Hoover book at the time. This was like the year of Colleen Hoover for me. Hopeless, I'm putting in What the Fuck Was I Thinking. I tried rereading this book once and it was like I blacked out when I read it the first time, and then I tried reading it again and I was like, what? It's bad. It's bad. Like the plot twist, the stuff that happens, it's bad. Ugly Love, I'm taking back. And then maybe someday, this was definitely at the time my favorite of them. You know what? I'm not gonna shit on all of Miss Colleen Hoover. I'll put maybe someday and stand by it because of all of Colleen Hoover's books, I understand why this one was my favorite at the time. If I had to reread one of her books again, I would pick this one. So I'll stand by it. It's not a favorite anymore. It does involve cheating, but for the time, I stand by it. Then we have Alienated. Don't remember who this is by. I don't remember it at all, so I'm gonna take it back. I honestly feel like if I can't remember anything about a book that I said was my favorite, I just need to take it back. Then we have Saga, which I'm putting in all-time fave. This is my favorite comic series ever. I've read it many times. I'm so excited for the next volume to come out. Then we have Amulet. This was also the year of like me and comic books. I was reading a lot of graphic novels and comic books. This was a really fun one. I stand by that. Rat Queens, I'm taking back for the sole reason that the creator of it is trash. Then we have The Kiss of Deception by Mary E. Pearson. I vividly remember this book. I remember how much I loved it. However, I never finished this trilogy. And I feel like in order for me to say if it is a favorite, I have to finish the trilogy and I would have to reread it. So I'm gonna put this in need to reread. Then we have Angel Fall, another trilogy. I feel like this is another one that I would need to reread. I really, really liked this. I feel like at the time that I read this, it was giving me like more new adult vibes than YA, which this was kind of like before like non-contemporary new adult was a thing. But I remember really loving this. But again, like I don't have that much memories about it other than it being like more gritty and darker than a lot of the other YA books that I was reading. Then we have The Book of Ivy by Amy Engel. This actually got a new cover. The original covers, they're pretty ugly. The new covers are gorgeous. I am sort of split on this one because I definitely stand by the first book. It's a duology, a dystopian duology. I loved the first book. However, the second book wasn't very good. So I don't know. I'm like, I stand by the first book, but I take back the second book. So I guess I'm standing by it because I put the first book on my favorites list. I did not put the second book on my favorites. The next one is, what is this? Lullabies? I think this is a poetry collection. We're going in What the Fuck Was I Thinking. This is another one. I think I was lying. Not that I don't like poetry, but a poetry book being in my favorites, No. And I can't tell you a thing about this poetry book. I was a liar. Okay, the last book for 2014 is Falling Kingdoms by Morgan Rhodes. This is the first book in the Falling Kingdoms series, and I'm standing by it. The series isn't an all-time favorite. There's definitely specific books in the series that I love. Some of the books in the series, not as much. But overall, like, I love the series so much. And I also stand by it for the sole fact that this is the book that led me to meeting my two best friends, who I've been friends with since we all read this book together. Okay, now moving into 2015, we have The Raven Boys by Maggie Stiefvater. I'm gonna stand by this. It's not a favorite anymore. I never finished this series. I read the first two books. I really liked them. And then I remember I was trying to read book three and I just could not get into it. So it's not an all-time fave, but I definitely remember like really, really loving it when I read it. The next one is Stray by Rachel Vincent. This is one that I think I would need to reread. It's a paranormal romance and I remember really loving the first book, but for some reason I never continued with the series. Okay, then we have Killing Sarai. This is the first book in the Company of Killers series, which I've read the whole series. I love this series. I'm gonna put this in all-time fave. I've read it multiple times. Next is On the Island by Tracy Garvis Graves. This is one that I feel like I would need to reread for the sole reason that it is a romance about a student and teacher who gets stranded on this island and they're there for like 5 years. I remember their romance like doesn't start until he's over the age of 18, but I don't know. I remember I loved this book, but I feel like I would need to reread it as an adult to see what I think of it now. The next one is Dark Fever by Karen Marie Monning. This is the first book in the Fever series. I was obsessed with the series. If you guys followed me in 2015, you'll probably remember me being obsessed with the series, and I want to say that I stand by it. I do, however, I feel like I need to reread it because I read the series over the course of like 5 days. I binged it. I was like obsessed. But when I do that, I feel like it's harder for me to really like judge if something is actually a favorite or if I was just obsessed with it. Because something being a favorite and being obsessed with something, I think are very different. Because I get obsessed with terrible things all the time. That's gonna go in the reread. Also, I don't know if I've said this, but I am planning on actually rereading the books that I'm putting in the reread tier. So it's not just for shits and giggles. I actually want to do a vlog where I'm rereading them. The next one is Written in Red by Anne Bishop. I feel like I'm gonna stand by this. I remember feeling like this book was very different from a lot of the other things that I had read at the time. It's like a paranormal urban fantasy. I read the first two books in the series and then I never continued with it. I think I stand by that one. Next, we have Illuminae by Amy Kaufman and Jay Kristoff. I don't remember like the actual plot of this book, but I remember that I really liked it and I thought that the mixed media elements were cool. However, I'm taking it back because I can't stand Jay Kristoff. He annoys me so much and I will never read any of his books. This was the only one that I had read and it is the last. Then we have Everything Everything by Nicola Yoon. This book I have very complicated feelings about because I have really fond memories of this book because this was Nicola Yoon's debut book and I got an ARC of it at Book Expo and I remember I was the first person in line for her signing, and when I got up there she told me that I was the first person who she had ever signed a book for and she wanted to take a picture with me to like commemorate it, and she wrote this like really special note in my copy of this book. So I have those special memories. However, I do take back this specific book being a favorite. I think that you can see coming up I have another Nicola Yoon book, and I take back this one being the one that is my favorite. I think that the criticisms that people have around this book are very valid, and I feel like as a person with a chronic illness that is very debilitating, if I read this book today, I wouldn't like it. And I wouldn't like the direction that it goes and the lens that it takes on illnesses. So I take that one back. Then we have The Winner's Curse by Marie Rutkowski, which is another YA fantasy trilogy that I never finished. And I remember that I really, really liked this book. However, I feel like I would need to reread this in order to determine if it is a favorite because I remember that the romance in this book takes place between the main character and a slave. And I don't remember much beyond that, but like, ugh, I don't remember. And I don't feel comfortable saying it's a favorite since I don't remember. Okay, then we have You by Caroline Kepnes, and I'm gonna put this in all-time favorite. This is one of my favorite thrillers. I think this was one of the first thrillers that I ever read or really enjoyed, and I still love it. I love the show. So that's going an all-time fave. Okay, and then the last one from 2015 is Lock and Key. It's a graphic novel series, and I'm gonna put Stand By It. I really enjoyed this one. It is a more like horror graphic novel series, and I also liked the show, so we're gonna stand by that. Okay, now into 2016. I only have 5 favorites from 2016, and for context, this was like one of the worst years of my life. So I was like going through it. I didn't even have the happiness to choose more than 5 favorites. I was like, there's only 5 and that's it. The first one is The Female of the Species by Mindy McGinnis. This is like a sexual assault revenge book, and I'm gonna stand by it. It's not a favorite. I've read a lot of other books since this that has a very similar premise that I like more, but I stand by that. I think that was a really great book. Then we have Ash by Melinda Lowe, which is a sapphic Cinderella retelling. This is another one that I'm going to stand by. This was, I believe, like the first or second queer book that I ever read in my life, and it kind of changed the game for me, but I don't think I loved it enough for it to be an all-time fave. Next is The Sun is Also a Star. This is the other book on here that I have by Nicola Yoon, and I'm gonna put this in all-time fave for the sole reason that this is probably the only YA contemporary that I would still want to reread, or that I would recommend, or that I would still call a favorite. YA contemporary is just like not my genre. Okay, then we have Every Heart a Doorway by Seanan McGuire. You guys know this is an all-time fave. This whole series, all-time fave. And I am an OG fan. The last 2015 book we have is The Long Way to a Small Angry Planet by Becky Chambers. And for years, I've considered this to be my favorite sci-fi book. However, I recently realized I don't remember a thing about this book. I remember the characters. Like, I vividly remember all the characters, and that was why I really loved it. However, I can't tell you anything that happens in the plot. So I feel like I would need to reread it, because I know that this is a favorite book. I just don't remember enough of it to like say it's an all-time favorite anymore, but I want it to be an all-time favorite. So now we are going into 2017. I feel like this was like my reading renaissance. This was a year that I was really branching out of my comfort zone, reading from a bunch of different genres, reading more adult books, reading themes, and just different books that I normally wouldn't have picked up. The first book from 2017 is The Fifth Season by N.K. Jemisin. This is immediately all-time fave. This is one of my absolute all-time favorite books. N.K. Jemisin has since become an all-time favorite author. I've read almost all of her books and loved every single one of them. And I still think that The Fifth Season is my favorite of hers. Say Yes to the Marquess by Tessa Dare. I think that on this favorites list, I didn't have a specific Tessa Dare book that I mentioned. I just mentioned her as an author. I think I read like 10 of her books in this year. I loved all of them. I'm sticking with it. All-time faves. She is my favorite historical romance author. We have The Roanoke Girls by Amy Engel, and I'm gonna stand by this. This is like a Southern Gothic mystery that I really, really loved. Then we have Homegoing, and this is another one I'm standing by. This book is fantastic, but it's not an all-time fave. It's not something that I think about all the time. This was kind of the book that I remember reading and realizing that I can enjoy adult books. Then we have Little and Lion, which I'm gonna be honest right now, I have no idea what this book is about. Not even a thing. Genre, plot, I can't tell you a thing about this book, so I'm gonna take it back. It could be a great book. It's not in my brain anymore. They Both Die at the End by Adam Silvera. I'm going to stand by that. I really loved this book. I loved the concept of it, and I think this was a book that helped me realize that I really like contemporary stories that have a little bit of a speculative twist to it. The next one is Eliza and Her Monsters, and this was a book that I remember when I read it, I thought that this was like Fangirl, but better. So I'm gonna stand by that. We took Fangirl back, but I'm gonna stand by Eliza and Her Monsters. Then we have The Hating Game by Sally Thorne. Listen, do I think this is a bad book? No. I remember I loved this book. I don't really know if I loved this book because of this book or just because I was discovering how much I love romance. So I'm gonna take it back. Sorry. I did love the movie. The movie was fun. Okay, then we have Binti, which I'm gonna stand by. This is a trilogy of novellas that are really great. I feel like this was kind of like dipping my toes into sci-fi. I wasn't a big sci-fi reader back then, but I remember how much I loved these novellas. Then we have Forest of a Thousand Lanterns, probably my favorite villain origin story. You know what? We're putting in all-time fave. However, the sequel to this, No. Sequel to this is terrible. So this is a standalone in my brain. But then we have Language of Thorns by Leigh Bardugo. This is her collection of short stories that take place in the Grishaverse. And I loved this. Like, I loved this more than the Grisha trilogy. I think I liked this even more than Six of Crows. I loved Six of Crows, but like, I just loved this collection of stories. And then my last book from this year is Born a Crime by Trevor Noah, which is the first and I think only nonfiction that I have in here, and I stand by it. I really, really loved this. I remember it being very funny, but also very educational. Okay, so now we're in 2018. 2018, I think, was probably one of my best years of reading. I read the most that I've ever read, not including this past year. I was really coming into my reading taste and figuring out exactly what I liked. So this first book we have, Into the Drowning Deep by Mira Grant. This is an all-time fave. This is one of the first horror books that I read. It's what I read that made me discover how much I loved horror books. Then we have Jane Steele, which is all-time favorite. This is a Jane Eyre retelling where she is a serial killer. Then we have Hate to Want You, and I'm gonna stand by it. It's not a favorite romance anymore, but I really, really loved this trilogy. Then we have The Book of the Unnamed Midwife, which I love. It's an all-time fave. This is a post-apocalyptic book. It's very dark and difficult, but it was so good. Then we have Spinning Silver by Naomi Novik. This is also an all-time fave. I loved this. It is a standalone fantasy, which I think this book was like what made me realize how much I love standalone fantasies. Then we have Sisters of the Winterwood, which I kind of feel like I always pair this with Spinning Silver, even though they're very different. This is also a standalone fantasy. I really love this. It's a retelling of Goblin Market, but it's not an all-time fave, so I'm just gonna put it in standby. Then we have The Wedding Date, which I'm taking back. This book is bland. I don't like fade to black romances. I know that now, so we're taking that back. Then we have The Kiss Quotient, which is an all-time favorite. I loved this romance. A Curious Beginning by Diana Rayborn. You guys know, recently I reread this book and I decided it's an all-time fave. Then we have Strange Grace by Tessa Grattan, and also The Queens of Innes Lear by Tessa Grattan. So this was the year that I discovered how much I love Tessa Grattan's books. Strange Grace is an all-time favorite. I love this book so much. It's so underrated. And then Queens of Innes Lear, I also really loved. It's a Shakespeare retelling, but I'm gonna put it in standby it because I don't think I loved it as much as Strange Grace. And like, if I had to choose one, I'm choosing Strange Grace. And then the last one from this year is Jade City by Fonda Lee, which is an all-time favorite. I think that this is probably one of my top favorite adult fantasy books. I loved this book so much. So now we're into 2019. I would describe this year as like me getting more into horror. A lot of the books on my favorites list this year were horror books. So the first one that we have is If We Were Villains, which is an all-time favorite. I love this book. It's one of my favorite thrillers. Then we have Vicious by LJ Shen. I have complicated feelings about this book because I don't like LJ Shen anymore and I won't read any of her books, but I did really like this one. But it's also a bully romance and I don't like bully romances, and I've always said that this one is like the exception. But I'm gonna take it back because I don't recommend the book. And I feel like saying I stand by something means I still would recommend it to people. So we're taking it back. Then we have Wilder Girls by Rory Power, which is an all-time favorite. I loved this book, and I feel like my love for this book grew. Then we have The Simple Wild, which I think is, oh, I don't know. I either stand by it or it's an all-time fave. You know what? It's an all-time fave. Then we have Well Met, which I'm standing by. This book was really cute. I really loved this romance, but I don't think it's an all-time fave. I don't have like an emotional attachment to this book like I do with The Simple Wild or the other books in my all-time faves. The next one is This Is How You Lose the Time War, and this is an all-time fave. I love this book so much. I've read it a couple times, and I feel like it gets better each time. Autobiography by Christina Lauren. I'm gonna take it back because I don't remember this book. And I know that I really liked this one, but I don't know why this is the one that I put on my favorites. Then we have The Girl in Red by Christina Henry, and this is an all-time fave. I stand by it. I feel like I stand by it. This is a really great post-apocalyptic book, Little Red Riding Hood retelling. I really want to read more of Christina Henry's books because I feel like as an author, she could be an all-time favorite, but this particular book, I know I really loved, but I don't think I love it enough to put it in all-time faves. Then we have Daisy Jones in the six. I'm just not realizing that Seven Husbands of Evelyn Hugo is never in here, and now I'm wondering why I didn't put that on one of my favorites, because I liked Seven Husbands of Evelyn Hugo more than Daisy Jones. We're gonna pretend that Evelyn Hugo is in here and she's in all-time faves, but Daisy Jones, we're gonna do Stand By It. I love this book. I'm so excited for the show. The next book is Rules for Vanishing, which is an all-time fave. I love this. It's such a great YA horror book. It's so weird. It has kind of a game element to it. The Monsters of Ellenhaven, another horror book that I stand by. I love this one. Not enough for it to be an all-time favorite, but it's such a great horror, gothic, monster novella. The Luminous Dead by Caitlin Starling is an all-time fave. This is a sci-fi horror that I love so much. Birthday Girl by Penelope Douglas, I'm putting all-time fave? Okay, we're putting it in all-time fave for the sole reason that this is a book that made me discover I love boyfriend's dad tropes, which I feel like is kind of the romance trope that I'm now known for. So for the sole reason of this introducing me to that, she's going in all-time fave. And then the last book from 2019 is The Beautiful Witch. I'm gonna stand by it. I remember I really loved this. I went into it with such low expectations, which might be why I ended up loving it so much. So now my 2020 favorites, which I hopefully should not be taking any of these back since it was only a year ago. Black Sun is an all-time favorite. I cannot wait for the sequel. Over the Woodward Wall, I'm standing by it. I feel like I would need to read more of this series before I call it an all-time fave, but I loved this one. The Library of the Unwritten, I'm putting this in all-time fave. When I read this book, I was like, obsessed with it. Girl Serpent Thorn, I'm putting in Stand By It. House in the Cerulean Sea, you guys know, is an all-time fave. The First Sister, all-time fave, such a great sci-fi book. Another book that I'm so excited to read the sequel. The Strange Case of the Alchemist's Daughter is going in all-time fave. I've read this whole trilogy now and I love it. It's definitely like in my top favorite series ever. Written in the Stars and The Wicker King are the two K. Ingram books that I read. I became obsessed with K. Ingram and I'm gonna put, honestly, I want to put both of them in all-time fave. I don't think I can choose between the two. They're so different and I love them both for very, very different reasons. And then lastly, The Year of the Witching, which I'm gonna stand by. This was really great, dark, witchy, fantasy. Okay, so that is all of my previous favorite books ranked. I really like seeing that the two fullest categories are all-time fave and stand by it, because I want to still like my favorite books. I don't want to sit here and be like, oh, you know all those books I said I loved? I actually hate them. So that's good to see. There are a few that I need to reread and I will be attempting to do that this year. For taking it back, honestly, there's not a lot that I took back, but like these all make sense to me why I took them back. And then the what the fuck was I thinking? It's just because I'm an idiot and a liar. If you haven't already watched it, I posted my 2021 favorites video, so I will link it and you can go see what those favorites are. Thank you guys for watching and I will see you in my next video. Bye!